Hello, in today's video I will show you some nice tips and tricks that you can use to get more fun out of Cube VR. The first tip is actually something really handy, and it is related to mining, or especially mining gold. Gold is one of the rarest things in Cube VR, and a lot of people struggle to find gold. After some time you get a pretty keen eye and you can spot gold under the sunlight or even the moonlight if you're lucky enough. But most of the times you don't walk around looking at mountains to see gold on the outside. So usually you go mining for gold. And then when you find gold, it's really hard to spot. For example, this block here is actually a gold block. Doesn't look that different, right? But there's an easy way to distinguish the gold, and is placing a blue torch. If you place a blue torch, the gold actually becomes visible. You can even remove the normal torches here. And as you can see, with just the blue light, the gold becomes easier to spot. So if you want to find gold, use blue torches. Getting blue torches is actually pretty easy. I made a video about it. You can just use the crafting recipe to make a blue torch, or you can just recolor an already existing torch with blue dye. And then you can see the gold. Then there's another thing that I already covered, but I will cover it once more because it's pretty important and a lot of people miss this. It's your tools. I mean, yes, the sledgehammer is actually pretty fun and nice and makes a lot of damage, but the sledgehammer does not always drop items. So if you want to get the gold, don't use the sledgehammer, because the sledgehammer has a high probability to break the gold. So instead, go with the pickaxe. With the pickaxe, you can just nicely excavate the gold, and then you definitely get the gold from your gold ores. So, nice. So here are still 3 gold, and using the sledgehammer can actually, as you see, I destroyed about 4 gold ores and I only got 2 gold nuggets. So if you really want to mine for gold, try using a pickaxe over the hammer. Same goes for iron ore and for copper as well, and even for some crystals sometimes. So the next tip I have is actually a bit easier or good to know. I already covered that you can change the reach of your placing rod by putting a crystal in your hand and using your touchpad if you're on the index. Other than this, you have this red slider where you can increase and decrease the reach. Another nice way to increase or decrease the reach is actually by grabbing the block and then just extending. You see? This way you can also get to the minimum and maximum reach. Getting back is a bit difficult, so you have to use the slider. But for reaching out, you can use this as well. So if you want to have it just like a little bit, just grab it and then you can move it. If you don't have your bow or your stick in your radial menu slots, just remove the uppermost left tool or item from the slot, because underneath this slot there is the actual stick. As you can see, the the stick is always available, it can't get deleted. So if you have something over your stick, like a pickaxe, just remove the tool or block that is on the most up left row in the menu slot. Then you get your stick. And for the bow, it's actually the slot right below where the axe is right now. If you remove the item from here, let's say you put it in your inventory. Oh, there's no place, okay. So let's just make some space first. Sorry about this. So, as you can see now, if there is a block over the actually bow, there is no bow, but it's not deleted. You can just take the block or item that is on the second row, and then you get your bow back. Here you can see I got my bow and my stick. So if I place something over them, like a hammer and a compass, there is no stick and no bow in the radial menu. But if I remove the compass, I got my bow back, and if I remove the hammer, I got my stick back. So it's always nice to remember that if you remove the top left tool or block, you get your stick back, and the slot below actually gives you the bow. Another nice tip is actually efficiency. When you have your crystal in your right hand, you can place up to 9 blocks at once. And every second block that you get is actually free. That means if I place 9 blocks, it will only use 4 blocks from your inventory. If I place 3 blocks, it will use 1 block from my inventory. And if I place 5 blocks, let's think that this is 5, it actually only uses 2 blocks. Maybe you already figured out what I want to say. If you're using an uneven number of placed blocks, the game actually round up to the last digit. That means if I place 1, it uses 1 block. Placing 2 still uses 1 block, because 1 is for free. And if I place 3, I get 1 block for 3. And for the half block, that is actually the half between 3, is also free. That means if I place an uneven number of blocks, I always get 1 additional block. So if you're placing some really rare block that is not really that common, or you don't have much of, try to use uneven numbers to place, so that you always get this nice 1 additional block. You can also move the blocks that you placed, so it's actually not really that you just use a useless block or something. You can, for example, if I want to have 4 blocks here, I can still place 5 blocks and move the 5th block here. Then I have my 4 blocks that I wanted, and even the next one, or I can put it here. So that's for the efficient one. Thanks for watching. I hope those little tips can make your QVR experience a bit more fun. Thanks for watching, and bye!